In this video, we learn about the soot blowers. We discuss about three topics in this video based on soot blower. First, what is soot blower and its parts? Second, what is the purpose of the soot blower or necessity of soot blower? Third, working procedure of soot blower. Let's discuss about the first topic. What is soot blower and its parts? Soot blower is a device, as you see is in the screen, for removing the soot that is deposited on the internal furnace tubes of a boiler during combustion. Now we discuss about the parts of the soot blower. Soot blower consists of two main parts. Those are head or chest and nozzles. Chest is the base of soot blower. It gives the support movement of the spindle. Next we discuss about the most important part, nozzle. The nozzle of the soot blower incorporates a passageway having a convergent segment between its entrance end, most narrow point, and the throat, extending from throat to nozzle exit is an expansion chamber to which cleaning fluids, means superheated steam, passing there expand and drops the pressure. As a result, in a high velocity jet of fluid impinging upon the suited surface. In case of automatically operated soot blower, there is an electric motor which operating soot blower spindle through the reversing gearbox. There is a flexible coupling between the reversing gearbox and gear drive. It rotates the gear drive. As gear drive start rotating, it rotates the operating screw which operates the spindle to move in or out. There is a cam constructed on the spindle which operates the opening of double setup valve. There is also a valve operating mechanism to actuate the opening of the double setup valve relevant to the spindle movement. The steam inlet. There is a double setup valve to hold the high pressure superheated steam unless it losses and the boiler efficiency goes down. On this spindle, there is a machine sump ports through which steam goes to the spindle are called steam ports. The base of soot blower is the spindle which holds the nozzle and provide rotating motion to the nozzle by giving path through it for superheated steam. On the casing, we see the cooling air inlet. As we pointed, which the part of the soot blower, through this port, the cooled air to the wall box tube is going in. Normally, taken this cooling air from the forced draft fan discharged before the air heater. Now we discuss about the second topic, necessity of the soot blower. As you see, the soot blower can minimize the rise of the soot fire. Such fire can cause hot spot to appear in the furnace tubes, which can then reach a temperature and weaken the structural integrity of the tubes. It also prevents plugging of the gas passes and maintain boiler efficiency. Now we discuss about the operating of the soot blower, how it is operated. As the electric motor start, they start to revolve the gear, which is situated in the reversing gearbox. By the movement of the gear through the flexible coupling, it is goes to the gear drive. As the gear drive operated, the operating screw start to revolve. As the revolve and there is a threaded portion, it start to move out the spindle from the box outside of the blower to the inside of the chamber. As the spindle moves in, the cam which is situated on the spindle start to move out from the initial position. As you move out on the, it start to at the extreme point, it pulls down the handle. As the handle pulled down by this valve actuating mechanism, operating mechanism, it pull out the double setup and the steam goes into this point, and through the steam it goes into the spindle and the nozzle, and the steam passes through the nozzle and impinging on the suited portion of the tubes. Now we see the animation of the how it is work. As you see, as initial position, the steam is already rested on the double setup valve, because the double setup valve situated and hold the steam at this position. And when the double setup goes out, as you see the animation, the moves are down, steam is goes out through this portion, and the steam start to out of the soot blower and start to impinging on the sooted surface. By this mechanism, the soot blowers working, and during the working time, by the revolving of the gear drive and the spin operating screw, at the extreme point it is locked. At the operating point, the spindle is open locked, and it is start to revolving the spindle. As this spindle revolving, the nozzle also revolving, and almost 360 degree portion, it also clean the all soot on the tubes. Now we stop about the discuss on the soot blower. If you like